just a... You know, Shannon's a racer. There's only one spot on the throttle pedal for him, and that's pretty much wide open.
Be told you never saw him in trouble with the law since the day of the morning. Facing the curve. Flattening the hills. Someday the mountain might get him with the law. Making their way.
And he's a damn good driver in that thing, and it's very nice to be able to drive with somebody that's got that experience, and that's you know, not trying to take me out, but just a hard racer and good competition.
The first vehicle I had for competing with was a 78 CJ5, and it was nothing special, and took it out and beat it and broke it. And then the next one after that, we built ourselves. It was all handmade, and you know, built the frame, built the tub, everything. And it was pretty much a homemade vehicle that looked like a Jeep and had Chevy parts in it. And that's what we started with, you know, started from the bottom. And people kind of liked what we were doing and started paying us to do stuff. And I started doing it on the side, and then it turned into a full-time job.
I tried working on it, I just couldn't get it. I was having fun, and so I was just getting ready to turn on the dumb switch.
I had a good time. Good job, bro.
Chen has this thing where instead of just winning the race, he wants to demolish the field.
The intricacies of rock crawling were, I couldn't understand them. I couldn't understand this guy with his big badass car, you know, taking on these guys and actually forging that whole side of the off-road community. I mean, Shannon is a pioneer in that, and he's made so many people look at this part of the sport and influence so many guys and builders.
He was always the guy that was, you know, smoking the tires and, you know, throwing rocks into the crowd. You always knew where Shannon was on the course.
Everything was built on the basis of a simple idea of, you know, laser cut stuff, a small jig, you know, grind stuff by hand, weld stuff by hand. Today, obviously, you see the car that's sitting behind me is totally different concept now.
We're all here, we're all just guys in Jeeps doing cool stuff. And we're the guys, you know, you go out on a trail, you find somebody broken down, you help them out, you get off the trail. That core value kind of thing is intrinsic through all our racers. And the Campbells epitomize that.
Nothing, I just tuning her up for the main.
He'd just pop in, start welding away, making stuff work. He had that eye. If he had an idea, he had the ability to make it work and actually come up with new and unique stuff.
I think Shannon's a rare person. His talent way exceeds his sense of self-importance and ego. And that's the nice thing, he's a great ambassador for not only Ultra 4 and off-road racing, but just for recreational off-roading in general.
Yeah. You guys have fun? Lots of carnage out there, huh? Right.
There, now turn up the hill. Go again, full throttle. Okay, stop. Go, go. Go down the hill. Go down the hill.
I probably got one of the biggest volunteer and best crews. These guys are everyday wheelers, so they know what's going on. When something happens, they know how to fix it with nothing. My dad used to make chicken salad out of chicken shit. Most of these guys know how to do that, and that's why, you know, they're my crew. They're nice enough to volunteer, and we try and take care of them in ways. I mean, there's so many of them, it's hard to even think about paying them, but treat them like friends throughout the year, and, you know, if they need something, anything I got, pretty much I'll give it to them or try and help them with it. And you know, what comes around goes around, and I'm very happy to have these guys pitting for me and on my team.
I've been watching Shannon Campbell compete, and then fortunate enough to compete against him. Beat him a couple times, got my butt beat a lot more than that. And now I've been fortunate enough to be a promoter and be able to try to give him a place to show his skills. And his skills are obvious, right? I mean, you win races, you're obviously talented. He builds cars, and his cars do well. He's obviously talented. but what's not necessarily always evident until you meet him and shake his hand and know him for 5-10 minutes is what a great person he is. And it's not just him, it's his whole family. You know, Don probably beat it into him pretty well. He's doing the same to Wayland and Bailey now. There's class people. And when you take that kind of class and integrity and you put it with that kind of skill and talent, you end up with an awesome champion. And that's what Shannon Campbell is.
We had Patty and Vern, and they were our EMTs for the event. Patty, unfortunately, came down with cancer and ended up getting sick. She still made her way out there and tried to do the best she always could. And they didn't have a lot of money, and they were going through some hard times. And hell, Shannon, he turned around and signed that check over to Patty and Vern, and it was probably one of the coolest moments we've ever had. Southern nights, just as good. Evening.